STIR, the 1.2 STIR subsystem, and that system does perform tracking of the target, both aircraft, fighters, bombers, but also missiles, cruise missiles, etc. Is able to pick up the target at a 50 kilometer range for fighters and a 30 plus kilometer range for missiles, and then tracks the target and guides the semi-active ESSM missile towards the target. It is capable of controlling a salvo of two missiles towards the target, and based on a semi-active ESSM missile, it does provide the illumination to the target. The ESSM missile is a very capable missile, very agile, very fast missile. And as Thales, the Netherlands, we have more than 30 years experience in guiding, tracking and guiding the Sparrow ESSM missile family. And this is a ground-based version, so we are moving along with deploying the ESSM missile in a ground-based application. The difference between the ground-based version and the naval version mainly lies in packaging. Obviously, in a truck there is less space available to package the equipment. So we have improved to high reliable solid state transmitter technology packaged in the housing, in the structure, so it's brought upward to have less line losses for transmitting the radar energy. So it's a very condensed package, and in the truck we only need power supply and the missile guidance unit that does the calculation for guiding the missile. So the integration tasks rest with our Polish partner, WZU. You see the interior of the system mounted on the KTO Rosomak truck. The supply from the truck comes with obviously electrical power, dry air and cooling. Then inside the truck we have the supply and amplify cabinet to provide all the power for the radar system, and the missile guidance unit that does provide the control and the guidance calculations for the missile. It initializes the missile before launch. As you can see from the launcher, ESSM is launched in a vertical position and then pitches over into the direction of the target based on target information received from the missile guidance unit inside the truck. During the flight, the target information updates are uplinked to the missile, and in the end stage a illumination beam comes on to guide the missile to the target. By making use of that feature of the ESSM missile, we can support two missiles in flight, so a salvo of missiles towards one target, where the system has the growth potential to further evolve to controlling two missiles to separate targets, dependent on the separation of targets. We are proposing this as an upgrade to the existing system to fill the short to medium range requirement of the Polish shield. It would be very beneficial for Poland to reuse part of their existing equipment that has long technical life, and by doing that reduce the cost, the investment cost, and still have a very state-of-the-art tactical capability with the ESSM missile guided by our radar. The system does provide for future growth. Thales, the Netherlands, is very well known for being the first to have a multifunction radar based on electronic steering of the beam. The solid state technology that we have incorporated in this concept is similar, is identical to the technology that we use for multifunction radar. So selecting ESSM with this radar option does provide a growth path towards the future, and also with the ESSM missile supported by a consortium of 12 nations, any future obsolescence is not a risk for the Polish customers.